Before the video starts, I would like to say that this video was mostly unscripted, as well as this is literally just my perspective on things. If things were different, please let me know, but this is what I know to have happened over the previous years, and my experiences in this group and with these people. Hello, everyone. I know I don't typically make videos like this, but this is an exception to the rule. I need to speak up. I used to be in a community of creators that made Sonic fanfiction projects. These projects were scripted, voice acted, and typically used stills or original art to portray scenes of many things. I left the community back in 2018, as it made my mental state deteriorate. The main creator I knew would have drama behind the scenes on a near daily basis, as well as the subject matter got to me in a very personal way, such as including my personal trigger words in the same script I was meant to voice what they considered a terrorist. While I stayed in the project to voice some less important characters, someone was nice enough to take that role and save me the headache. That was one of the last projects I voiced in, but it was enough to make me want to quit the community. While I may not have needed to state this, I felt it was important to emphasize I used to be in the community. I used to make projects of my own, and I know the people that are still mentally ill to this day from everything that had happened. None of us were perfect back then, but I literally jumped into the community as a 13-year-old dealing with constant bullying, harassment, and had just gotten out of a major surgery a little over a year prior. Life was hard, and I was trying to find my way around it. That's why on May 13th, 2015, my life changed by meeting a content creator by the name of McInerney76. He was a very sweet and humble young adult, instantly becoming the light of my beginning teenage years. He made videos and projects that could easily make everyone in his growing circle of friends smile. By August, we were part of a big Google Hangouts group that would call daily. By November, the group had only grown. Everyone there had a passion inside of them to create stuff much like David's work. He really was an inspiration. Even if the content was questionable, it gave tons of young teens something to strive for, myself included. Grief hit that man hard in August 2015, sadly. He became prone to sadness, quickly going down a rabbit hole. We tried helping him, but most of the people in said group were just starting high school. We didn't have the life experience or the knowledge needed to help a suicidal man. While the group stayed together mostly, it began to crumble a bit by the beginning of 2016. Drama was a daily thing. Everyone was constantly upset from the influx of problems, death threats, and generally not knowing how to help anyone anymore. Some of us had jumped ship from the main group into a much smaller one meant for a specific VA project. And from there, the drama scaled down slightly for us. But David leaving chats was still at least weekly. In the same year, coincidentally, his projects took a turn. They became much darker in tone with Revenge of the Deadly Six. The final part especially is described as a war in his later works, already showing a differing style than before. Nobody minded though. In fact, this made a lot of people's projects get more serious in tone. However, a different problem showed up that nobody really paid any mind to. I would now like to skip forward to 2017, where the main person this video is really about, AnnaGameGirl23, came into the fray. The friendship started off fine enough. She drew him a piece of fan art and he featured it on stream, leading to her finding her way into that friend group. When she joined, I was not there anymore, but I was in contact with friends who were. They seemed to imply that drama had exploded around the time, with her wanting to be the main source of attention. It was all fine, at most an annoyance when she showed her childish wanting of attention. However, that was when people found out she stole her characters. I go into detail on that here, but I've already written a segment on that for my good buddy Mal. That video should be up sometime soon. You'll see what I mean then. I'll summarize that she stole her character's OC design from a person on DA, got someone to design another, all the while she stole another random OC from DA, and when we asked her about either of them, she got suicidal and literally said that we murdered those characters. Nice guilt trip. We're not stupid. After this, we kept seeing her generally guilt-tripping David on livestream for the following 4 years. We would try to genuinely help him, but get shafted and banned in chat for even daring to say that he should seek professional help. She silenced us, blocked us so we couldn't say a word, and then shit-talked us behind our backs, even when things seemed friendly. Then again, I always had a feeling she disliked me in particular. I can't speak on that further because the evidence of that's long since deleted, as if she really did have something to hide. Now, why do I bring all this up now? Simple. She's still at it. She's trying to get away with stealing the same original OC design too. Hell, she even mentioned in a now-deleted stream that people tried to kill her OC. You know, the exact phrasing she used back then? It's scummy. She's hiding behind a block. I need this video to reach those in the community. I need them to see she's trying to be slick. She's trying to manipulate and gaslight you all. If you still don't believe me, I did all I could. Listen out for the other video. Please know I'm coming out as a person who just wants to help a man I literally talk to daily for over 2 years. Laurel, please, just warn.